people, you welcome back to the channel. I know I've not been consistent and you guys have been waiting for me to upload, and I'm here today. Sorry for keeping you all waiting. I want to say thank you to all those who have been following me. If you have not subscribed to my channel and you're watching me today, kindly do so. Hit on the bell icon to always be notified once I post a new video. Today my driver is taking me to the shop. You're my driver now. Because I scratched the car, and I'm going to give you details on that. As a new driver, you know, you'll be making certain mistakes, but not one that can cause your life like it nearly did to me. Yes, and I've learned so much lessons from it. And sometimes you think that accidents are so far away from you. Trust me, accidents are so closer to you as a driver, or once you are boarding a car. But I think day in and day out, we go, we come back, and nothing happens to us. Hallelujah. And in Ghana, accidents, road traffic accidents, is one of the top 10 causes of death. Trust me, it happened to me, and I think I'm going to do best. I'm going to be sharing with you some mistakes I made as a new driver, and I think that these mistakes are going to also be helpful to new drivers as well. Imagine even tell you these mistakes. So
I'm going to find out on this channel then. And point of correction, I'm not her driver. I am Kimbo.
You are Kimbo, really?
Yeah.
Okay, that's Kimbo. Yes, he's my baby. Okay, so the first mistake I made, I think I was going to work. It was on a Sunday. And you know, as a new driver, you know, when you see your friend, you want to bluff smart. It's not like I want to bluff. I saw my colleague and I wanted to pick her.
So okay, to me, this is confession. Because I don't know about all of these mistakes.
So I wanted to pick her. Instead of me stopping to pick her, I drove past her, and what I did was I turned. As a driver, instead of me to drive forward, I turned backwards, and immediately I turned, the car veered off the road. Babe, there was this pavement around, I think it was on the gutter, I don't know how to, they did this pavement around where you park, and just beside the gutter. That was what helped. And it ran over some of the pavement, and those standing nearby was like, hey, then I stopped. My heart was beating. There were these gentlemen who helped me. They told me to drive, so they used this, I don't know, sticks under the tire. Yes, and they told me to drive.
So they use it as a lever so you can drive on.
Oh yes, and I was back on track. So that was the first mistake I made, and I told myself that I'm never going to turn. I'm never going to look back. Anytime I'm driving, it's either I stop or I go. I'm not going to look back. Yeah, so that was the first mistake I did, and I thank God, because it nearly went into the gutter. So when I got off, I was like,
so that's how come you got a scratch, huh? That's another episode.
So I was like, God, thank you. Okay, did you make any mistakes as a new driver?
Yes, I did. I think when I was going for my license the first time, I didn't get it because I drove too close to the curb and ran over the curb. You know, as a new driver, sometimes you are too afraid to make the turn, and then you go too close to the curb. So I guess that's similar to the mistake you did.
Okay.
But I didn't fall into any gutter.
I nearly fell in a gutter. Yes. And the second mistake I did, I don't know, that one made me feel very bad. I felt so bad because that was the first time I was hitting something. I was driving, and I won't say I was speeding too much.
Was I speeding too much? It wasn't too much, but yeah.
I was within range.
But a key thing as a driver is to be observant of the road.
Yes.
You should always pay attention to what's going on around your car.
Yes.
There was a, I think it was
let
a
goat,
right?
Say it myself.
Oh,
yes.
Okay.
There was a goat crossing the road. Because I was speeding, I was not able to slow down for the goat to pass. Okay. So all I had to do was to hit the goat. That was the biggest I don't know, because it made me feel very bad. I was like, had I hit a human being, where will I be by now?
I think what she failed to do is anticipate what was going on the road. You know, animals are very erratic. Sometimes they seem to be crossing the road and they can, you know, turn back again. So I think in her case, that's what happened. The animal was crossing the road and it suddenly stopped. And she couldn't stop in time, so she hit the goat. But tell them what you did afterwards.
Yes, and you know, because I was speeding a little, I drove off and turned. I wanted to see the owner of the goat so that I could tell her what had happened. We turned back, we didn't see the person. So there were people around that we told them what happened, and they were also happy because for the first time someone hitting a goat, coming back to report it to the owner was a new thing to them. So they were also happy, and they told us that God should bless us. Before I was relieved, even though I was relieved, trust me, I felt so bad when I was driving, and I was like, had it been a human being, was that how the person was going to die? I was
By the
so
way,
mad.
We are here at the shop.
Okay. Okay, cool. Good morning. If I try to say. So I felt so bad. I felt so bad. When we got back to the hotel, I felt so bad and I was down. My husband was asking me, you should learn from this. So that was when he was telling me that when you are driving and you are reaching a point where animals are crossing, from far you have to slow down for the animals to cross before you go. The mistake I did was I didn't stop because I was somehow speeding, and I didn't have to brake. I just had to hit the animal. Yeah, I was waiting for you. And the other mistakes I did that I've corrected, you corrected me, that I've learned from you is, you know, when I'm driving and I'm getting closer to a pothole, you told me that from afar I should spot the potholes and then decide on where to pass. I don't do that. I was not doing that at first. I'll just go straight to the potholes. It's either I'm braking or it's either I'm just
That all boils down to your observational skills. So you have to spot the potholes from way back, make your decision where you're going to pass. That will be less dramatic.
Really?
Exactly. So And once you make that decision, you stick with it. I think one thing that she was doing was she wasn't, I felt like she was, what do I call it? I'm trying to find my words.
Okay, find it and tell me. Find it, I'm waiting.
She was hesitant. Whenever she saw a pothole, she would try to go over it and then make another decision to pass somewhere else. Obviously, we'll make
I was not taught that in driving school, so
that's why you have to drive for a while before you get your license. You have to learn all of that through driving.
Okay, but I'm trying.
Yeah,
I'm trying, right? Yes. Overall,
I think you're doing a great job.
Wait, me,
because she actually climbed the Quelt Mountain, so which is pretty intimidating. So I think she's doing a great job.
So how are you going to rate me? Of 100%.
So I don't think any driver is perfect.
Okay.
But even me, I've been driving for years and I don't think I'm perfect. Yeah. So I think you're doing a good job.
Thank you.
As they say, you learn from your mistakes.
Yes.
So I think as a new driver, you have some hesitation. But as a driver, you have to believe in your skills. Moment you hesitate, it could go wrong. So you have to make a decision and stick with it.
Yeah, I think there is no perfect driver, okay?
If there was perfect drivers, we would not have any accidents.
For
so
sure.
There's no perfect driver, but there are good drivers.
There are good drivers, yes, and I'm trying to be a good driver. I want to be a good driver, so I'm not going to make those mistakes.
Who's going to pay for it?
You, of course. Babe.
I thought I was the driver.
You're my driver and my boo boo. So today, please pay for it for me. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this video and you learned something from it as well. Until then, we are the most.